Hello everybody, my name is Ákos Kata, and today I would like to show you how to do audio modding in REDkit. First of all, I would like to show you how to create a simple sound event in device, and also how to generate soundbanks and how to reload them in the engine. And after that, I would like to show you how to reference these audio events with the generated soundbanks in the REDkit. First of all, let's see if Wise is installed inside our PC. No, on our PC, let's go into the publish cook mod sounds, and it will throw us a fatal error because Wise is not installed. Please go to the Audio Kinetics website. Let's create here a new account, and after that, you will be able to download the Audio Kinetic launcher itself. And with it, you can install the Wise. One important note is that Wise should not be newer than the 2021.1.7 version. With newer Wise, it will unfortunately not work for now. So please, let's not install newer than this version. So if I open up Wise, then let's open up the assets folders with a free audio project. It's inside the Steam installation, inside the editor, assets V3 audio, and it has this Wise project here. Let's open it. Accept. And now let's try to create a new soundbank. Inside the soundbanks folder, let's create a child. Let's name it test. Let's create a new event as well. Let's name it test and the new audio event as well. Let's make it test. And if you right click here in test, you could import an audio file. Let's import something from the Windows media folder. Let's add the file. And let's search for media. Wise only accepts WAV files mainly, so I recommend using WAV files. Let's open up one of these files, maybe this. Let's import it. And you can also hear it. Awesome. The events are used inside the game and inside the editor. So if we have our raw audio file, then we can create an event out of it, which then we can reference inside the game. Let's create a new event with child, test windows, and add an object which should have a chord chord name. Let's browse for it. So again, browse object. It should be inside here. Yes, test. Perfect. Let's play it once more. Okay, and let's go into the soundbanks. Let's create a new soundbank. Let's name it test. And double click on it and link a chord inside it. Perfect. Let's generate the soundbanks for it. And it will tell us that no valid license is imported inside the audio project. This warning should also pop up inside the editor if we try to cook mod sounds again. License key is not embedded inside the project. By itself, you need to acquire your own license. Please go to the Audio Kinetics website and let's create a new project. Let's register a new project, and inside it, now please choose non-commercial and more than 200 sounds, click proceed, and name your project as VGF-free mod. This way, Audio Kinetic will easily identify it as a VGF-free mod. And they will provide you with a key, which you can embed it inside your project. So if you have your key acquired, then Inside Wise, you could go into the project, license manager, and let's paste it from our clipboard. Let's save it. And now you should be able to generate sandbanks. Sandbank generation is needed in order to use them inside the game and editor as well. So let's try it again. We have our license key embedded. Let's right-click, generate sandbanks for current platform. Perfect. Now our test bank has been created on Windows platform. And now let's go back to the editor. And now, because our license key is embedded, then it will not pop up with another warning once more. So we should go to the publish, cook mod sounds, and we should see our test bank at the beginning of the list. This list is sorted by the last modification date. So you should see the newest ones first. Let's tick it and let's generate the sandbank cache file for it. It should be finished, and inside our workspace folder, we could actually see the content itself inside the packed mods mod audio content folder. This can be loaded back as a mod inside the game. And now let's try to do something else. Let's open up Novigrad. And let's play on the current layer. It should be fast. And let's open up the behavior debugger tools. Should be in debuggers. Behavior debugger. It should be player zero. Let's search for it, membase and gameplay instance. Let's open it up and try to do some rolling. So when you're doing the rolling, this lower part is activated. Let's see it again. Here is the roll logic, roll start, and these are the animations which will be used if Geralt has a sword in his hand. These should be the ones, but they are not called anyway. There is the state dodge. And here it is. This is the one we are looking for. Yes, perfect. All right. Dodge. Well, let's see it inside the exploration once more. Maybe it's here, but we will see. Should search for not here. Okay, then let's look for it inside the movement itself. Dodge roll, nothing. Movement, nothing. Maybe it's inside the combat animations actually. And we have sword. And maybe we are doing a locomotion roll. These are the ones, okay. So when we are doing a roll, we are doing the roll flip RBB01. Let's select Geralt here. Let's close the other windows. No, I cannot select him because he is in the scene, I guess. Let's press F10. Let's close it. And let's select Geralt. This should be the one we were using. And now, let's use our sand event. Actually, we should reload it inside the editor. Let's select it with the, once again, tools, sound, reload sandbanks. Let's select the test bank and click OK. This way, the sandbanks will be reloaded and the new sandbank will be included inside the editor session. And now let's add inside the timeline. Let's right click and add a sound event. And the sound event name should be browsable. Let's try to search for test. It is not showing up. Let's restart the editor. Okay, the editor was restarted, and now let's see if we can find this new event inside the editor. Let's click on our new sound event and let's select for the event name. And here it is. This should be the one we were looking for. Sometimes, unfortunately, you need to restart the editor in order for it to work. Perfect. And now let's save it and try to open up Novigrad once again and see it in action. Let's try to play on the current layer. And now we should see and hear the new sound effect when we are rolling backwards. We actually changed the logic when Geralt is doing a backwards roll. And that's it. Thanks a lot for watching. Bye bye.